What do you do when you want to make a movie but you have no money and no friends? Okay, the second part might be a little bit harsh, but still, the truth remains, how do you make a movie out of nothing? My name is Braden Swope. I just wrapped my first feature film. Go explore the links to that in the description, but for now, we're talking about the horror short film that you hopefully just watched. Now, before we continue, I want to excuse my mouth because I just had like a big oral surgery, so I'm a little bit limited, but I'm gonna push through as best as I can. So back in 2021, I had a few ideas for what I kind of wanted to do for the future. I was coming off of my feature film. Human Resources had its premiere in August of 2021, which in my head feels like 3 years ago, but that huge event had just kicked off. I was very exhausted, but I was very craving of making something else. I was sort of in this very weird state. Another thing I was very broke. And being very broke is probably the worst enemy to someone ever who wants to make a film. So I figured I'd make something on a very, very, very low scale in comparison to the huge scale feature that I had just accomplished. I had been watching a lot of the YouTuber Pony Smasher's videos lately, and some of you might know him as David F. Sandberg, who made the Shazam film. He got his start making YouTube short horror films, and I had just been watching so much of his content, and I started to feel some semblance of like, okay, this could be something that I pursue. I've never done horror before Human Resources, my feature film, so I kind of wanted to go back and try that, almost as like this rite of passage to being a horror filmmaker. And then COVID got even worse, and I was like, okay, the idea of making a film with like a big crew and with money, it's just going out the window. And that's when I ended up landing on what you're probably here to the video about, which is the short film called Draw. And I was like, okay, what do I have? What do I have in this room that I could make this short film with? I'm not gonna go out and buy a bunch of equipment. I'm not gonna do anything wild. And so I have this Blackmagic pocket cinema camera, but I wanna stress that like, this is not important. I wasn't able to make this film because I have this camera or something like that. So if you have anything, if you have a DSLR, if you have an iPhone, if you have a GoPro, no excuses. Whatever's in your room now, go grab it and make a movie. So I started thinking about, like I said, horror. And I was also like, I don't even want to leave my room. So what can I do in this space to figure out how to make a film? And then I was like, what is it about this room, this space that could be scary? And I started thinking about like the mirror in my bathroom, the window outside there, I'm just staring outside at night. And then I kind of got excited and I pitched it to my girlfriend, Penny, who is the star of the film, and she was totally on board. And so I was like, okay, I have this actress. What could they do? What are some of the things that they could do in the film? Penny's an artist. At the time when I was writing the script, she had been in like a sketching class. And so I was thinking, okay, I always see her sketching at this desk right here. So let's do a movie about her sketching and then go from there. What happens from there? And she had never acted before. So I'm coming up with scenarios because of her. All these ideas came together. I threw together a 2-page or maybe it's 2.5-page script, and the game is set and matched, and I'm gonna make a short. So yeah, shooting went off without too many hitches.
This is day one of two of Draw.
Got my shot list printed here.
I gelled these lights here. You can't really even tell, but there's a little gel. Let's turn this a little warmer.
And Penny's putting up printed pictures.
All of them original designs, which is really awesome.
Just me,
showcasing
baby.
All your original designs.
Yeah, this is a pretty cool opportunity.
Rolling, rolling.
This is gonna be interesting.
Okay. Brayden Swope's return.
When I take one of Draw. And here we go.
We did it over the course of 2 5-hour sessions. Nothing extreme. It was pretty basic. It was over one weekend.
Now we're in the little lab services. McDonald's funded.
There's a light going on. Penny's doing her makeup.
Got that light on in that room, which is bouncing in here. I'll go show you that. Oh, it's actually reflecting back in here. I'm gonna be monitoring it for warmth.
So far, so good.
And I've got these mini aperture lights to do our flicker.
Which are these amazing handheld lights. They're great. They're customizable. You can do effects. Absolutely love.
And that's a wrap on day one of Draw.
And it was really fun, even though it was pretty exhausting.
Just me and Penny. It's tiring work when you don't have a crew.
I had my camera, very, very basic tripod. I threw together like a really crappy dolly that I threw on a few things that I got from Home Depot and screwed together that was very unsturdy, but I was able to rely on it once, and there you go. What else do you need? I think a lot of people get bogged down, you know, with the equipment side of things. I gotta have the perfect this, I gotta have the perfect that. I was doing very basic moves, pans and tilts, and very basic dolly. dollies in and out. It doesn't have to be, you know, a full gimbal crane shot from the top to your ceiling down to the bottom. It can just be on a piece of plywood on the ground, and there's your shot. There's your move.
Stay two of two here. Eventually, we're gonna be shooting out this window. Try not to get caught looking like a creep shooting a camera up at a window.
It'll be magic. We're tying a rope to a door, and we're gonna have Penny pull it.
It's like, wow, was that the wind? When in reality, it was Penny.
Ready, action. That was the one.
Another huge thing was thinking about, okay, I'm making a small movie on a very small scale. Is there something that we could really focus in on that would be like the total selling factor of the movie? And while you could maybe think that that's like the ghost effect that we ended up doing, I think it more so came in the huge like mural type painting we did for the end of the movie. Remember, I was like, Penny, how do we draw on a mirror and like not completely ruin a mirror? And she's like, I don't know. But then she thought about it, and then she came to the conclusion that we could use like finger paint, like to put on our mirror that would just be washable and wash off. And the effect in the end was just so incredible. That sort of ties together the movie at the end of the day. She made the original sketch at the end that the woman is also drawing. So like this movie could not have happened without Penny.
How did you accomplish that?
So we wrapped shooting and I thought that it went really, really well.
That's a wrap on draw. I cannot believe we pulled that off.
We did it. It's only 12:30.
And then I dove into the edit, which of course, as always, I think is the absolute most important part of your process. You really gotta work at that post because that's where you have like a very temperate, you know, controlled climate to actually work in, where things aren't just like do or die. You actually are able to take a step back and be like, okay, I can think about this for a day. While I was able to get through the edit relatively quickly, the one thing I never ever want to forget, no matter what type of movie I'm making, is the structure and the pacing of a project. I looked at my first cut of this movie, but it was still sitting at like 6.5+ minutes. And I looked at it and I'm like, this thing needs to come down. But I got a minute and a half off of that and I took out a few scenes, a few things that set up the character in the first act that I just thought weren't necessary. And I just challenge anyone making any movie, like think about your edit so critically. What can I take out and jump from point A to point D in a much easier way? Because usually you don't need to see point B and C. Another really, really cool thing was Penny also brought her newfound acting skills, regular acting, and also into like horror monster acting as well. Because not only did her and I set her up in this like ghost woman costume.
Oh, she's just a spooky ghost.
Just a ghost?
She is a demon woman.
Terrifying. But she also lent her voice acting skills to the project, which turned out really creepy and really, really cool.
We are back doing some draw stuff. I've got this temporary ADR set up, the jankiest thing you've ever seen. The challenge is going to be figuring out the right voice cadence. Hopefully we find something that's both scary, unique, and cool.
Hi, we're gonna do it.
I'm just gonna record this for my own curiosity.
Keep psyching myself out.
I've seen weirder, trust me. I've had Tony go. This is very normal to me.
So like, I'm gonna be up here.
Oh, that's so cool. That's unbelievable. Yeah. Whenever you're ready, just try, what are you doing? Why didn't you let me in?
What are you doing? Why didn't you let me in?
It was actually pretty hard to get the voice right for this because I was trying to think, I want this ghost creature to sort of sound like a child, and I sort of layered all of her takes together and added a lot of echo, so it sort of felt like, you know, a choir of people could be talking.
Alright.
Penny, you are a mastermind. That's a cut.
Another huge thing was the piece of score at the end of the movie when they're drawing together on the mirror. I reached out to one of the amazing composers from Human Resources, Nick Sedan, to create a piece of original soundtrack for that scene. Because for most of it, I knew that I was just going to be using soundscapes to build sort of the horror of the movie. But for that specifically, I just like, I'm not going to be able to find a royalty-free piece of music that works exactly for how I want it. And what a piece of score that he made. Like, it was so good in the end. And it really built to this very, like, weirdly emotional climax for the film. That was another thing that I thought set it apart. Hopefully, I don't know. I don't know what people think of it. No one's seen this but Penny and myself, so. Lastly, I was really excited for the sound and VFX portion of this process. I've been using After Effects since I was like 7, so every film I make, I have to have some sort of little trickery gimmick effect in there with After Effects. And maybe that's a good thing, maybe that's a bad thing. The first one is the drawing effect on the sketchbook in the beginning, which was done just by Penny pulling up like her iPad and just drawing the messages that I wanted, and I just layered and tracked them onto a blank blank piece of paper. And then for the ghost effect, which I really have not talked about too much here, it was really fun. We just ordered a wig from Amazon. It's like $6. I didn't think it was gonna work. And then Penny threw it on, but I also needed an extra plate to make it look like the ghost was see-through. So I just had Ghost Penny step out of frame for a second just to get that little plate and then layer that back on top. Sound design was also really fun, adding those creaks and those steps. I added all the extra Foley and even like chair squeaks and footsteps that just puts you into that world that's without that atmosphere and without those sound effects, you might not actually believe. It was tedious though, like I'm not gonna lie, it was very tedious placing like the exact light sounds underneath each flicker and make sure everything felt real even though it was all done in post. And then if you do that, you can end up with something that feels very dynamic. And hopefully this film was something like that. I hope you enjoyed it. And thank you so much for checking out a BTS like this. It means a lot to me. Sometimes you just wanna make a short film for yourself, and that was Draw. I had so much fun shooting a movie for basically no money and without a crew. I hope this was a little bit of insight into this tiny little short film. And if you haven't watched it yet, why did you make it to the end of this video? That's weird, that's confusing. Go watch it. Go ahead and check out more about NBD Productions. We have a feature that's gonna be coming out very soon, which has been done for a while. Yada, yada, yada. You don't need to know all those details. Just go clickety-click in the links down below. Keep on making movies. No excuses. Go do it. You better go do it now. Go. Now. Okay? All right, everybody. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Braden Swope, and I'll check you on the flippity-flip. Peace.